There are reports from Yemen leadership that he was killed, and that there are social media reports from within the organization that they've already replaced him. So it's pretty good evidence, but I can't confirm on behalf of the United States government. But if it's true, it is a significant blow. Leadership matters. And this guy really was the number two man in Al-Qaeda worldwide, and was certainly the number one guy in this very dangerous, as your reports have already indicated, very dangerous subgroup of Al-Qaeda in Yemen.